Wow, 6 months gone of 2021 already. I'm sure a couple of weeks ago, I was giving my predictions on Azure for 2021. Whether I was right or not, we will check at the end of the year. Now here in Australia, it's winter and we can go skiing. Yeah, really, we can. But Azure is built mostly in Seattle, where it is summer. And that means holiday, and thus the news of cloud goodness were, well, sparse. However, there is a very urgent message you don't want to miss coming up now. So hold everything you're doing. This week, a remote code execution vulnerability in .NET 5, .NET Core 3.1, and .NET Core 2.1 was fixed for PowerShell. Published back in March, the fix is now coming to PowerShell 2. Better late than never, I guess. This text encoding vulnerability also affects PowerShell versions 7.0 and 7.1, which Microsoft recommend you update to 7.0.6 and 7.1.3, respectively, right now. This was released in Microsoft Security Advisory CVE 2021-26701, which is linked in the description. If you don't update, there is a chance managing Azure resources through your PowerShell instance could provide an angle for attackers to execute code remotely, and that's bad. So update. No, do it now. Go. Go on. I have to admit, I don't know much about this piece of news, but it has Gandalf in it, and that's good enough for me. Oh, you want to know what Gandalf is? Right. Now, I'll start with AIOps, which is the use of artificial intelligence to enhance IT operations such as deployments. It might be a bit buzzwordy, but the use of machine learning and automations in IT operations is becoming more and more normal. The Azure Compute Insights team has developed the Gandalf Self-Deployment Service, an end-to-end continuous monitoring system for safe deployment. As Microsoft puts it, Gandalf monitors signals across performance, failures, and events. It pre-processes the data to structure them around a unified data schema to support downstream data analytics. In other words, Gandalf listens for tiny, teeny, teeny changes everywhere in the operations and feeds them to humans for action. Oh, why Gandalf? Well, because it serves as a global watchdog, which makes intelligent deployment decisions based on signals collected. Just like the White Wizard. To make Azure truly multi-cloud, you can use the Arc service. It lets you bring Azure services to any infrastructure and even extend your network to the Azure IoT Edge Computing Network as well. Beginning July 30th, 2021, the general purpose tier of Azure Arc enables SQL managed instance will be generally available, providing database as a service, or DBaaS, functionality on any infrastructure. This will mean you can deploy Azure SQL on any infrastructure and any Kubernetes cluster. This is another way to build a hybrid cloud infrastructure. So if you want Azure in more places, Azure Arc is for you. If you want to learn more about Azure Arc, check out the Azure Service Spotlight episode on the service. Link is in the description. If you missed out on all the awesome content at the ACG Community Summit last week, the sessions are available on the ACG platform now, or maybe now. Now? If you want to keep up with Azure news, consider subscribing to this channel. And if you like this video, give us a thumbs up, or that one. As we say on the A Cloud Guru team, when you find yourself in the marketing department and not quite sure if there's a budget for hats, seek and you shall cloud. So see you next week and keep being awesome, cloud gurus.